succeedschool.com. Learn to succeed.
Solids, liquids, and gases. Matter is made of tiny particles we can represent as little balls, although this is only a model and not quite right. But it'll do. The particles can bond to each other. In a solid, they're neatly arranged and touching, vibrating on the spot. In a liquid, they're still touching but moving over each other randomly. In a gas, there's big gaps between them and they move rapidly. The warmer something is, the more the particles are moving. Heating and cooling lets us change from one state of matter to another. Heating melts a solid into a liquid and evaporates a liquid into a gas. With a few substances, we can skip the liquid state and jump straight from solid to gas. This is sublimation. Cooling condenses the gas back into a liquid and then freezes the liquid as a solid. If we plot temperature against time on a graph, we get zero gradient sections for the state changes because breaking bonds as we heat takes energy and reforming bonds as we cool releases energy. These zero gradient sections are how we determine exactly what the melting points and boiling points for a substance actually are. For a more detailed description of solids, liquids, and gases, please check this video and click here to subscribe.